When the client-server relationship that resulted in this formation of a transaction tree completes its action, for example, let's say that the transaction tree got created as a result of a client opening a file, doing a bunch of reads of the file, writes of the file, and finally closes the file. At that point, that interaction between the client and the server is complete. That's when the transaction tree that has been created as a shadow of the original client server relationship will get into gear and say, okay, now it is time to clean up any resources that may have been partially created in order to satisfy that original client-server relationship. And it is the coordinator that initiates the termination of a transaction. And the termination initiated by the coordinator can be for commit or it can be an abort. And the different color-coded arrows show you what are all the kinds of commands that the coordinator may issue to its subordinates, who in turn will issue the same commands to their subordinates. If the transaction manager, the coordinator, decides that it is time to commit, it might ask for vote request on committing, or it might ask for an abort request, or it might send an end of commit or abort. These are all the communication that would be initiated by the coordinator of the transaction, and correspondingly, responses will come back up the tree commensurate with the request that was given. So using again the file service as an example, if a client that started a file service request crashed for some reason, then the transaction manager, that is a coordinator for that client-server relationship, will then send an abort request to all the participating transaction managers that got touched by that particular client as a result of that file service request. For instance, it could be a directory manager, it could be data servers that are hosting those files and so on. All of those transaction managers will get contacted by the coordinator through this transaction tree with a request to abort that particular transaction ID. And when they get that request, these transaction managers can do local cleanup, whatever that might mean, and indicate to the transaction manager by response that, yes, we've done what it needs to be done to clean up the interaction that was started by that failed IPC chain. All the different kinds of communication that I've indicated here are opportunities to tailor the commit protocols depending on the criticality of the states, that is, the nature of the breadcrumbs that are going to be left behind in the different servers. So, for instance, if the transaction tree is representing a client-server relationship between a client that opened a window using the window manager on the screen, then if the client crashes, then the transaction manager, who is the coordinator for that particular client, will indicate to the transaction manager at that window manager site that this particular transaction ID is aborting. And in that case, the window manager can simply clean up the state because the state that it has got is a volatile state, namely a window that it created on behalf of the client. So it can take care of it internally. It need not be persisted. On the other hand, if the interaction that we're talking about involves persistent data structures, for instance, through a file server, then the file server may have to take more complicated actions. So that is what this transaction tree allows you to do. Depending on the nature of the client-server relationship, you can choose to use different commit protocols depending on the criticality of the states that are associated and the nature of the breadcrumbs that may have been left behind in the different sites because of the client-server relationships. Persistent servers such as a file system may need a sophisticated commit processing such as a two-phase commit protocol, while a window manager may only need a simple one-phase commit protocol. So all of those are possible with the structure of the transaction tree and the kinds of requests that flow through the transaction tree, both down the tree and up the tree in response. And this is the heavy lifting that is done by the operating system in order to support different classes of services that might exist in the operating system, which may require different recovery management.